Hi everyone, I hope you all are doing well. I'm really excited to share with you guys my new and improved morning routine. Everything has changed since the last time I did this video, and that's because I realized that I was just not a morning person. In fact, Ryan started calling me the morning monster. So I did some research on the things that I could be doing to improve my morning situation, and it has really worked. And not only has it improved my mornings, but my entire day is now so much better and happier and more productive. So I hope you guys can get some different tips and ideas from the things that I share with you today. And if you guys do like it, don't forget to give it a thumbs up. And also be sure to stay tuned to the end of this video because there is a little giveaway involved somewhere in the mix. So look out for that and let's go ahead and get started. So here I am still sleeping, and the first tip I have that really helps me wake up in the morning is to let some natural light in. I find that waking up naturally with the daylight just puts me in a better mood right off the bat, and it's just a more pleasant way to wake up. So the next thing is probably the biggest game changer, and that is I immediately get up and out of bed. I do not stall in the bed looking at my phone. I don't even think about it. It's just an automatic process, and it helps just get me physically out of bed so much faster. So the first thing I do is head into the bathroom. I brush out my hair, and you might have noticed I was sleeping on a satin pillowcase, and this helps keep my second day curls intact, and it's also better for your skin, so I highly recommend using a satin pillowcase. After that, I will brush my teeth and grab my favorite cover-up. This is from Forever 21. I think it's so cute, and head on over to the kitchen to make my breakfast. So the first thing I make every morning is my tea latte, and that is actually my reward I give myself for getting out of bed earlier than I used to. So to make this, I recommend using filtered water. It just improves the quality and the taste of the tea. I boil off the water, and the tea I'm using today is a green jasmine tea. This tastes so amazing. I like to use 2 tea bags just because I like a strong tea latte. And to make the latte part of it, I just put about 2 ounces of milk in my milk frother, add that to the mix, and it is so tasty. This is my favorite morning treat and probably the highlight of my mornings, to be honest. So for my breakfast, I'm making a quinoa porridge. And a tip here is to eat a breakfast that has a mixture of complex carbs and also protein. This will give you sustained energy and prevent a crash. So quinoa works really well because it has the complex carbs and it's also a complete protein. You could make regular quinoa or you can use these quinoa flakes. I just found these at my health food store, and I prepare mine with almond milk and I add whatever fresh fruit I have on top of that. It tastes really similar to an oatmeal, but because it has the protein in it, it will give you more sustained energy. Then I head over to my desk area and I give myself about 10 to 15 minutes of me time in the morning. And let me tell you, these 10 minutes have totally transformed my day. The first thing I will do is put on my favorite music. I will sit here, eat my breakfast, drink my tea latte. And once I am done with that, I will do my morning aromatherapy. And this has become something I do every single day. I'm addicted to it. I was really skeptical as to whether aromatherapy really works, but our sense of smell is really powerful. And for some reason, these essential oils, they just put me in a really good mood. So because I love this so much, I wanted to do a little giveaway for you guys. I'm going to give 2 of you my favorite essential oil diffuser, which is this one, the River Rock, and also some of my favorite essential oils. The only thing you need to do to win is be subscribed to my channel and leave any comment. That's it, I'm gonna pick 2 of you guys to win. Then I take just a few minutes to write in my gratitude journal. I notice some people it might sound cheesy, but gratitude puts you in a good mood. It's just a fact. So what I've been doing lately is I think of one thing that I love and I write down all the reasons why I love that particular thing. And today's topic is my dog Bardot, which is really not hard to do because just look at that little face. The next thing I do after that is take out my planner and do my daily planning. So I work on my to-do list and my plan for that day. And that just gets me focused on the things that I need to accomplish that day. And that makes me feel less stressed and more in control. I actually did an entire video about my planning process, and I will have that link in the description box if you guys are interested. Then after all of that, I will finally go and check my phone. The first thing I will always check is Instagram. And then my second thing is Snapchat. This is a new development. I just got it about a week ago and I'm obsessed. I just like it because it's less filtered and more fun. And I love getting snaps from you guys. Here are a couple. After that, I will check Twitter, and then I will go on my YouTube channel and answer some comments. I think I've said this before, but talking with you guys and interacting with you is probably my favorite part about being on YouTube, so it definitely puts me in a really good mood. Once I'm done with my me time, I go and feed my dog, and after she eats, I take her on a little walk, just 5 to 10 minute walk, and not only is it good for her, it gets me moving, it gets my blood flowing for the next thing that I now do in the mornings, which is my at-home workout. So I used to work out in the evenings, but I've switched that to the mornings because it gives me more energy, it's a mood booster, and it makes me more likely to actually do it. As the day goes on, it's easier to find excuses. What I've been doing lately is 3 or 4 Blog Lottie's videos. I love her videos because there's a good variety and they're really, really tough. I usually will feel sore the next day after doing these videos. So once I'm done with my videos, I will drink some water and have a protein bar. I've been liking these Quest bars lately. They're pretty tasty and they have a good amount of protein, low sugar. Then I head over to the bathroom to do a little bit of dry brushing, which is something I recently added to my routine and I already really love it. Dry brushing improves your circulation. It helps expel toxins from the body. It also reduces cellulite and gives you smoother skin. Basically, it's just something really quick and easy to do that has a lot of health benefits. So you gotta love that. After that, I will hop into the shower and just rinse off, do some exfoliation of my body and my face. And then it is on to my skincare routine. So my skin has been feeling really dry lately, and a lot of people mistakenly think that if your skin is dry, you need a heavy moisturizer. It's actually the opposite. You want a serum moisturizer, which is a thinner consistency and has a smaller molecular structure, so it penetrates more deeply into the skin and gives you more intensive hydration. The same concept also applies to the eyes. I also use a serum here. And then I finish my skincare off with alpha lipoic acid, which is a skin smoothing antioxidant, and it helps with skin redness and overall skin texture. So I love this stuff. So since I work from home, I will typically wear no makeup. I let my skin breathe, but if I have to go out and run some errands and be in public, I will wear minimal makeup. So this is what I will typically put on. So my CoverFX drops, I love these. I mix them with an illuminating moisturizer. I'll put on some concealer. You guys know I love my Age Rewind. I'm trying the brightening formulation for the first time. It might be a little too bright. Still working out how I feel about it. I will do my brows very quickly just so it looks like I have eyebrows. I'll also put some Wedge by MAC just in the crease of my eyes and add some mascara. Right now I'm really liking this Perversion mascara. It gives very fluffy looking lashes. I will put on a bit of blush just to bring some color and life to my face, and I will finish it off with a sheer lipstick. This is Coral Bliss by MAC. So as you can see, it's super simple, takes me less than 10 minutes to do. And with that, an everyday outfit I would typically wear would be just a V-neck t-shirt and my favorite American Apparel jeans. I have these in every color, I'm obsessed with them. And that's it for my typical morning routine. I really hope you guys liked it, and don't forget to check the description box for more information on the giveaway. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you next week with a new video.